He ministers to people in Bryan College Station in Caldwell who are homeless, and he collects items. And Ron and I were at Walmart last night, and we picked up some blankets, those little roll-up blankets. You can get those anywhere from $2.50 per blanket to $5. And if you can maybe think about it, you could pick some up and bring those out there. We're just going to drop them off out there, and you can drop and go if you'd like. I think that he's going to do some type of a prayer for the homeless out there. So I want to encourage you on the 21st of December and at the courthouse here in Caldwell, if you could do that. Also, I want to clarify something about, I think Fred has said this too, but on Christmas Eve, Sunday morning service as usual, 10 o'clock, and then, of course, 6 p.m., our Christmas Eve service. So we'd love to see you in both of those services on that wonderful day. Where else is there to be but in the house of God on Christmas Eve? So the other thing I want to tell you about is the 31st, okay? Now, the New Year's Eve service is the group that we have the joint services together. We've been doing this, and we decided to go neutral on New Year's Eve. And because it's New Year's Eve, the theme of this is going to be Vision for 2018. And we're doing something very, very unique in that service, something that I have never done before. So, you know, you mean I'm a gamer. I'm going to try it with them. But we're actually going to all preach that service. We're not going to preach four sermons. We're going to preach 4 points. And we've been talking about time, and we have really been very consistent about that. And it's going to be something very, very interesting. We're going to mix worship in with the messages or the message and the 4 points. So we want to encourage you to come and see that. It's going to be just a great day. The Civic Center is actually closed on that day, but they kept it open because of what we were going to do. I think that was just beautiful that's the kind of people who live here in Caldwell. So I want to encourage you, 10 o'clock. We'll begin service 10 o'clock on New Year's Eve at the Civic Center. So we want you to be a part of that. All right. Would you please, don't stand. We're going to have our Advent candle by the Albrights. They're going to come up. All of them. Good.
Died. reflect again on the wise men, who remember their pursuit of the Messiah. We pray for the wisdom to search for the truth and to follow God's light. May we also be wise men to govern others to God's purpose.
Amen. Would you stand with me, please? I just love Cooper's inflection. He went back another way. Got a minister in training here. It's good stuff. Let's bow our heads and pray. Father, we love you and we pursue you, God. We chase you. That's why we're here today. Wise men have gathered in your house today to worship you in spirit and in truth. So, Father, I pray that you would receive us, that you would teach us, that you would bless us, that you would heal us, and that you would enrich our lives. So that when we leave here, we leave here like the wise men. We'll go back another way. And Father, we will be better than we were before we came. So we thank you for your grace and your power and your presence that will fill all of us today. In Jesus' name, God's children said, amen. Remain standing, open up your hymnals, or follow us on the screen, page 36. And let's sing all three verses of O Come, All Ye Faithful. Page 578 in your hymnals, or follow us on the screen as we read the Word of God together today. It's entitled Adoration of the Magi. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor, that shall rule my people Israel. And Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child. And when you have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When he had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star, which they saw in the east, went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. When they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. May the Lord God add blessing and understanding to the reading of his word. Before you're seated, look to your neighbor and tell them Merry Christmas as you greet one another. Merry Christmas. Our ushers will take their places at this time, receive our morning tithes and offering. And the children have a special presentation for us after the offering. It's going to be wonderful. Let's bow our heads and let's pray. Father, we bring back to you our substance. We bring back to you, Father, the results of our labors, and we give it into your house, and we pray that you would just take it, multiply it, bless it for your work. And I pray, Father, that we would continue to be a light on this hill, that we will shine your truth and your life to our community. We thank you for blessing the gift and the giver. In Jesus' name, amen.
above, ye heavenly host, grace, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. At this time, I turn it over to the Sunday School Department for our children's Christmas program. Be blessed. Amen.
there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish.
He ministers to people in Bryan College Station in the Caldwell who are homeless, and he collects items. And Ron and I were at Walmart last night, and we picked up some blankets, those little roll-up blankets. You can get those anywhere from $2.50 per blanket to $5. And if you can maybe think about it, you could pick some up and bring those out there. We're just going to drop them off out there, and you can drop and go if you'd like. I think that he's going to do some type of a prayer for the homeless out there. So I want to encourage you on the 21st of December and at the courthouse here in Caldwell, if you could do that. Also, I want to clarify something about, I think Freddie said this too, but on Christmas Eve, Sunday morning service as usual, 10 o'clock, and then of course 6 p.m. our Christmas Eve service. So we'd love to see you in both of those services on that wonderful day. Where else is there to be but in the house of God on Christmas Eve? So the other thing I want to tell you about is the 31st, okay? Now the New Year's Eve service is the group that we have the joint services together. We've been doing this, and we decided to go neutral on New Year's Eve. And because it's New Year's Eve, the theme of this is going to be Vision for 2018. And we're doing something very, very unique in that service, something that I have never done before. So, you know, you know me, I'm a gamer. I'm going to try it with them. But we're actually going to all preach that service. We're not going to preach four sermons. We're going to preach 4 points. And we've been talking about time, and we have really been very consistent about that. And we're going to, it's going to be something very, very interesting. We're going to mix worship in with the messages, and or the message and the 4 points. So we want to encourage you to come and see that. It's going to be just a great day. The Civic Center is actually closed on that day, but they kept it open because of what we were going to do. And I think that was just beautiful that that's the kind of people who live here in Caldwell. So I want to encourage you, 10 o'clock. We'll begin service 10 o'clock on New Year's Eve at the Civic Center. So we want you to be a part of that. All right. Would you please, don't stand. We're going to have our Advent candle by the Albrights. They're going to come up. All of them. Good.
The east went ahead until it stopped. they saw the star, they were overjoyed.
When the set time had fully come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those under the law, that we might receive adoption to sonship. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. May all kings bow down to him, and all nations serve him. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Sleep in heavenly peace.
Amen. I want to talk to you briefly today about this issue of Jesus coming into the world and what all this means. What it changed in our world, because it changed a lot. Today I want to just briefly bring to you the message, the life that Jesus brought. And there's a statement that we make a lot. We're going to address that. It's that statement that we often say, well, you know, that's life. But first, let's go to chapter 10 of John, verse 10. And listen to what Jesus says here. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. Now, I came that they might have life and have it abundantly. This is why Jesus is Lord at His birth, as Macy just sang. You see, Jesus came into this world and He introduced life. Different life than what we talk about. We often say, you know, to any situation that happens, especially the bad things that happen, I've never seen anybody come into a lot of money and say, well, you know, that's life. I got a promotion. That's life. You know, when my team won, oh, well, that's life. No. We often say that's life to bad things. I remember when my mom died in 2014. I was dealing and coping with that loss and the adjustments I would make. And I remember saying to myself, well, that's life. Just got to learn to go with that, and I can't do anything about that right now, but that's just life. I've talked with people who've been laid off from their jobs, and they'll say, well, you know, that's just life. People who've been diagnosed with illnesses, they'll say, you know, what can I do? That's life. When darkness and fear attack your family, we often just settle and say, well, you know, that's just life. Is it? Is that what life is? I want to challenge our culture today, because we often make that statement, and that's not life. It's what we've made it. It's what we've turned it into. It's what we've tainted it to be. But it's not the life that Jesus came to infuse into this world. See, what we're best at is corrupting things, making things that were good, we turn them to bad. God takes what is bad and turns it from good. We take what is good and we turn it for bad. You want an example? I was thinking driving up here today about that point. And I thought, God gave me a perfectly good body and look what I've done with it. You see, we tend to make things worse. Jesus brought life into this world, and it's good. When Jesus was born, Lord at His birth, He came in and said, I'm introducing something else. Every Christmas, we take a glimpse of life. We experience the light. Some of you may have already been driving around seeing some lights. Joy, generosity, except in the parking lot at Sam's. Hope, faith, we learn to share, right? Tidings of comfort and tidings of joy. These are glimpses of life. Not what we do, not what happens to us, but glimpses of the way things are supposed to be. You see, this is the life that Jesus brought with Him in that tiny little stable, laid in that manger in swaddling clothes. He brought us hope. He brought us joy. He brought us a life that transcends what we made life to be. We live in a sin-cursed world where people suffer. Now, that's what we call life. I want to challenge you. Instead of saying that's life, I want you to think that's suffering. When my mom passed away, that was suffering. My dad's in hospice, that is suffering. You lose your job, that is suffering. When relationships begin to crumble, that is suffering. It's not life. I want to show you a quick example. Two very quick little videos that come off of movies you may or may not be familiar with. But let's see the first one right quick.
Life is pain. Get used to it. We'll skate all the way to the shore, Princess, and you will not fall again.
The next one.
You mock my pain.
Life is pain, Highness. Anyone who says differently is selling something.
Interesting. We are constantly taught that life is pain. I mean, the media says it. I mean, by their behavior in the last year, we should believe them, right? No. Life is not pain. What we have done to it is. Suffering is pain. But the life that Jesus brings, He brought a gift in this world and said, here, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. And then He says, I've come to bring you life. Life more abundantly. And what do we do with it? We call it pain. We call it suffering. Friends, the enemy can shout that all he wants. And foolish people can say it wherever they want to say it. But as children of God, we need to differentiate between the two. We need to understand what suffering is and where it comes from, and what life is and where it comes from. I choose life. Amen? When bad things happen to me, I'm going to call it what it is. That sin, that is what came into this world, that is what I have done to what God has promised me. I have corrupted the good life God has given me. And that is why I live under the curse of sin and death, because I have sinned. But Jesus has come to give me life, and that more abundantly. God gives us life, we rebel. And we've defined it now as pain and suffering. And then God comes back and says, you know what? I'm going to introduce life into the world again. And He gives us this gift that we get a glimpse of every year. This Jesus. I came that they might have life and have it abundantly, Jesus said. So today, remember this. Suffering is pain. That's what suffering is. It's pain. Life is Jesus. And He is your destiny. He is your goal. He is what we're supposed to be. And He has come to take our suffering. He said, cast your cares upon me, for I care for you. My dad used to always say, God's shoulders are big and strong enough to handle anything that happens in your life. He can carry it, and He will, if we'll give it to Him. Because Jesus is life. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verses 19 and 20. And I close with this challenge that Moses gave the children of Israel. Listen to what he says. I call heaven and earth to witness against you today that I have set before you life and death. I set before you blessings and curses. And what does he tell us? Choose life so that you and your descendants may live loving the Lord your God, obeying Him, and holding fast to Him. That means life to you and length of days so that you may live in the land that the Lord swore unto you to give to you and your ancestors, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob. This is what God has given us. So when the world calls life suffering, ignore it. I've often told my kids, lead, guys. Lead, don't follow. When people call life pain, you just... No, I'm not buying that. I'm not buying that. Life is Jesus. Suffering is pain. Let's choose Jesus today. Child of God, know the difference and embrace God's life. Bow your heads with me and let's pray. Father, we love you and we thank you for this glimpse that we've seen today of the Christmas story, of how you were born, Lord. Born, Lord. Born, King. Born ruler of all things. And Father, we embrace your life. And God, we just take our pain and we call it what it really is, suffering, that are results of the curse of sin and death. But Father, we embrace you. We choose to embrace tidings of comfort and of joy. I pray that your life will fill each and every one of us as we yield to you today, giver of life, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Amen. Stand with me, please. And let's sing our final song. We're going to sing verses 3 and 4. Joyful, joyful, we adore.
Thou art giving and forgiving, ever blessing, ever blessed. Wellspring of the joy of living, ocean depth of happy rest. Thou our Father, Christ our brother, all who live and love are thine. Teach us how to love each other, lift us to the joy divine. Mortals join the mighty chorus, which the morning stars begin. Father, love is reigning o'er us. Brother binds man to man. Ever singing, march we onward, victors in the midst of strife. Joyful music lifts us sunward in the triumph song of life.
Amen. And amen. Let's give these kids and these adults a good hand of appreciation for our program this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. And my gift to you is 10 minutes early. Amen. Amen. Go with God in the power of His might. We'll see you here next week on Christmas Eve service. It's going to be a great day, both at 10 and at 6 p.m. We're going to have a great time. God bless you. You may be seated and dismissed.